In this lesson, we'll take a look at the new adjustment tool interface. We'll find out what's new in the app. The very obvious ones are the layer and the pencil tabs. Once you click the layer, it allows us to use the adjustments for the whole layer. But if we click pencil, we'll be able to use the adjustments only on the painted area. This is very convenient because sometimes we want to change the color of a specific area in the layer. You don't have to click the selection before changing the color. You can use pencil in the adjustments directly. The next one is gradient map. This one is pretty interesting. It's a tool that allows us to play with light and shadow in the picture. When you tap it, you'll find many gradient styles. I think it's similar to adjusting the mode in Photoshop. Let's try choosing one of them. You'll notice that the darkest color of the picture is on the left and gradates to the lightest color on the right. In addition, we can create our own gradient by tapping the plus icon on the right. You'll see the picture in black and white. We can choose the color weight that we want. The darkest or heaviest weight will be on the left, then it gradates to the right, which is the lightest color. If you want to swap the color weight, you can try that as well. Play around with it as you like. We can tap on the screen to choose the command that we want to use with the gradient. We can undo our actions, preview the outcome, cancel the gradient, or apply the gradient. If you change your mind and you don't want this gradient style anymore, just click cancel to cancel it. The next one is the adjustments. Bloom. The bloom will add dreamy light to our picture. I don't know how to explain it to you other than using the word dreamy. Once you tap this option, you'll see a bar with additional settings below. To use it, just move your pen to the right. You'll notice that the app brightens the lightest color in the picture up, making it look bright and dreamy. You have the transition adjustment on the bar below. It's used for adjusting the light's clarity. The size is for adjusting the size of the dreamy light. The next one, burn. This is to adjust the brightness. It can be very bright that you'll feel as if you're blinded. It's like the light in heaven that you see in movies. The more you increase it, the more blinding it'll feel. But don't overdo it. Don't make it look overwhelming to the point that we can't see anything we've painted. The next one is glitch. It's a very cool effect that the app recently added. To use it, move your pen to the right just like what you did with bloom. We will see the multicolored squares appearing as an effect. It's like we're in a sci-fi movie. You can choose the style of the glitch as well. The first style is the artifact that you're seeing right now. The amount is used for increasing or decreasing the number of squares. Then, the block size is for adjusting the size of the squares. The zoom here allows us to zoom in and zoom out. It's very detailed. The next one is wave. The wave gives an effect that looks like electric waves. It's like you're watching a TV and there's an interface. You can adjust the amplitude, which is the width of the waves. And you can adjust the frequency of the waves as well. You can also zoom in and zoom out or increase the number of waves with zoom. The next one is signal, which is like combining the two previous effects together. You can use it by moving your pen left and right as usual. The options are similar to the artifact effect. The amount is for adjusting the amount of the square blocks. The block size is for adjusting the size of the square blocks. And we have zoom, which allows us to zoom in and zoom out. The last one is diverge. When you use it, it'll give a more blocked effect to your picture than the previous three effects. We can shift each color separately. The red and blue colors, the pink and green, and the dark blue and yellow, all of which are complementary colors. The last one is zoom. You can use it to zoom in and out as usual. The next effect that the app recently added is the halftone effect. I'll call this effect the printer effect. Once you use it, you'll notice that the app changes the shape and color values in the form of dots. The dots combined and became our picture. If you used an old printer before, you'll remember the dots on the printed page. Printers these days are much better, so you can barely see the dots on the printed images nowadays. Let's look at our options. The first one is full color. If you use this one, you'll be able to see the original shape, but with dots on top. The next one is screen print. It changes the shape that we painted into the form of dots. The last one is newspaper. It'll make your work become black and white, just like how a newspaper would look. We can also use a finger to tap on the screen for further options, just like the gradient map. The last effect is this chromatic aberration. A rainbow effect? A drunk effect? I don't know what to call it. You'll notice the overlapping colors while this effect is in use. In addition, we can also set the perspective point. We have additional options here. The first one is the transition, which is used for adjusting the overlay. The next one is the falloff. We use this option to adjust the overlay radius. If you want the rainbow overlay to be only around the edges, increase the falloff. The next one, displace. It'll separate each color into channels. We can adjust the position as we like. It has two settings. Blur is for adjusting the blur of the colors. Transparency is similar to adjusting the opacity. You can control whether you want the colors to look distinct or faded. Try to have fun and play around with all the effects as you like. That's all for the adjustments in Procreate 5X. See you in the next lesson.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like or leave a comment and subscribe to my channel. As a thank you, loyal subscribers receive a 10% discount on my Procreate Masterclass. Check the description for coupon code. See you in the next video.